To be honest, I kind of grew up with the notion that, you know, in the Hebrew scriptures, God was, he was really mad. In the Old Testament, God was just mad. And he was just, he kind of, I don't know, I had this picture that he kind of set up on his throne, you know, and then he just kind of waiting for people to step out of line, you know. Oh, whoa, stepping out of line. Step out of line, I'm going to have the earth open up and swallow you, boy. That was the picture I had of God. As a matter of fact, later in life, that led to some serious spiritual problems in my life because when I messed up, I started running from God. And just like God chased Adam saying, where are you? God kept chasing me. And I kept running. Why? Well, I was running from the big stick God. And here's what I mean by that. I thought God wanted to beat me with a big stick for being bad, and that's why he was chasing me. Do you know why he was really chasing me? Because he missed fellowship with me. He missed me being his friend. Creator God of the universe could miss you or I if we're not fellowshipping with him? Absolutely. Why do you think he chases us when we're out of fellowship? Why do you think he tells us stories like the one of the prodigal son where the father was looking and he saw his son a far way off is what it says. How did he see him a far way off? Because he was sitting at the window waiting and looking. Friend, when you wander off, that's God's heart towards you. He's looking. He's waiting. He's seeing when you might come home. Finally, a friend, Christian friend, who I was kind of afraid of seeing, came to me and was talking to him, and he said, you know what? I love you, and I miss you. And tears came to my eyes as I realized that was the heart of God. Not come here, I want to beat you. Not come here, I want to whoop up on you. No, the world had done its, it had taken its toll on me. God said, come here, I miss you. And I love you. Come home to me.